CIET-NCERT presents curriculum-based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 5.
Hello children, how are you? I hope you and your dear ones are safe at home. As you know, you cannot go to school due to COVID-19, but you need not worry. In a few weeks, school will reopen and you can go back, meet your classmates, play with your friends and learn new things. But for now, I will help you with your studies at home. I am your friend Akanksha and today we will talk about something that is loved by all children. Yes, you have guessed it absolutely correct. I am talking about playing, but not alone, with all your friends. Can you imagine that? You must be wondering why I'm talking about playing together instead of studying since we are in a learning session. That's because we will discuss a poem on teamwork. It is in the unit 2 of the Marigold Book 5, your English textbook. If you have the book, then open page number 21. If you don't have, it doesn't matter. You can still listen to the poem. Later, you can read it when you get the book or a photocopy of the book. Don't worry at all. Let us listen together to the poem titled Teamwork by Jane Negro. It teaches us about the importance of teamwork. So let's first listen to the poem.
Teamwork.
Let's sing and dance.
Teamwork, teamwork. Together we can make our dream work. Then we'll share the joy of what we've done. Teamwork, everyone.
It's fun to shoot the basketball through the hoop. But if nobody passes, then nobody shoots. And the relay race just can't go on if nobody wants to pass the baton.
We are the parts that make up the whole, and we've got our eyes on a common goal. Sometimes it can be a big plus when a you or a me becomes an us.
Poem by Jane Negro.
Hey, I'm back. Did you like the poem? Did you sing along? I am sure you have the meaning of most of the words. But now, let us understand the meaning of some more new words and find out what the poet wants to say. I will be reading the very first stanza for you. Teamwork, teamwork. Together, we can make our dream work. Then, we'll share the joy of what we have done. Teamwork, everyone! The first stanza begins by telling us about how teamwork can contribute to making our dreams come true. As we all know, teamwork requires the effort of everyone. When we see a dream, we want to achieve it. Teamwork can help us in achieving it well. The very first line of the poem inspires children to dream big and make their dream work together. Moreover, the joy that we get after achieving our dream doubles when we share it with our team of friends. The lines from the stanza clearly state this, and I quote, "Then we'll share the joy of what we have done. Teamwork, everyone." And that sharing also brings happiness for everyone too. Thus, even celebrating the victory of teamwork will be great. Isn't it interesting, children? Now, let us move on to the second stanza. Very quickly, I'm going to read second stanza for you. It's fun to shoot the basketball through the hoop, but if nobody passes, then nobody shoots. And the relay race just can't go on if nobody wants to pass the baton. Further, the poem moves on to the game of basketball. It tells us that to score a basket, everyone needs to work. How? Together. When the basketball goes through the hoop, it is the effort of everyone on the team. Now can you see, children? It is the effort of everyone, each and every player on the team. Now children, I would like to put your attention to the word hoop. A hoop which is spelled as H-O-O-P is a horizontal, circular, metal hoop shaped which supports the net through which players try to throw the basketball. For if people do not pass the ball, no one will be able to shoot it in the basket. That's obvious. And one thing, children, did you notice? You have to say shoot. S-H-O-O-T. Shoot. Shoot it in the basket. Interesting. I know. Shoot it in the basket sounds little odd too, but we say it like this only. So next time you play basketball with your friends, use this vocabulary, children. Similarly, the poem also gives the example of a relay race. That sounds so interesting. A relay race, yes, children. In the race, one person has to pass the baton to the other. I am very sure you know how to play it. However, if one player decides not to do it, then they won't be able to succeed or even finish the race. Yes, you heard me correctly. If any one player decides not to do it, then they won't be able to succeed or even finish the race. Thus, teamwork matters a lot in every situation. The poem concludes by telling us that we are all parts of one whole. What are we? We all are parts of one whole. Let me share an example with you all. You must have seen a car. If you see the car closely, you will notice how a car is a whole, but it runs because of its many parts, like the steering wheel that helps in turning the car. The wheels take it forward. The engine keeps it going, right? The fuel tank stores the oil and supplies it to the car to provide constant energy. So, the entire car is made up of these little things or parts which further constitutes to be a car. So next time you see a car, think about it, children. Watch it closely and observe the others which make it a whole car. Thus, teamwork matters a lot in every situation. The poem concludes by telling us that we all are part of one whole. Now, do you remember, children? What did I tell you in the beginning? The poem also concludes by telling us that we all are part of one whole. No person is bigger or smaller than the other. Everyone has their respective roles to play. In school too, let's take another example. Each person has a role to play and a certain time to do it in. Someone rings the bell, someone teaches, someone else sweeps the classroom for you, someone cleans the toilets. Even if one person, children, Imagine this. Even if one person decides not to play his or her part, the whole school will be affected. Would you agree with me? Yes, you will, I know. Just think about it. At the time of house construction, there are different professionals. I am taking another example, my children. Construction workers work on construction sites. They are responsible for a number of on-site tasks, such as erecting scaffolding, loading and unloading building materials, and assisting with heavy operating equipment. The architect's role is to transform the client's needs. An architect is involved in planning and drawing of this design, as well as overseeing its construction. The electrical engineer, on the other hand, is responsible for all the electrical specifications and installations too. A contractor has a wide range of duties and responsibilities. So, my dear children, when everyone comes together to achieve a common goal, it will be better. This way, everyone will have the same purpose and they will do their jobs equally. So, it says that you and I become us. And even better, you and I and some of your other friends become a we and work faster and better as a team. And this then becomes the basis of our teamwork. Let's discuss a few think and write questions from your English textbook, Marigold, Class 5. Now the first question is, name the team members needed for the following. So children, since we have just read a poem on teamwork, we'll now answer these questions. Number 1, to play cricket, we need... Think hard or let me help you. Yes, to play cricket, we need batsmen, bowlers, fielders, and most importantly, what do we need, children? We need coaches. Moving on to the second one. Second one says, to make a film, we need... Think about it, children. To make a film, we need... I'll help you. To make a film, we need directors, actors, and the most important, yes, viewers. Right? I know you must be enjoying it. Now, let us move on to the third one. To run a good school, we need... Think about it, children. To run a good school, we need... Yes, I'll help you. Principal, teachers, helpers, and my most favorite, students. Moving forward, I would like to put your attention on another important phonological awareness concept in your book, Marigold Textbook Class 5. It talks about rhyme. Dear children, rhyme is found in poetry, songs, and many children's books and games. Most of you also love to sing and recite rhymes since nursery. Words that can be grouped together by a common sound, for example, the at family, that is A-T. At family, cat, hat, and sat can be used to learn about similar spellings. You can use these rhyme families when learning to read and spell. Let us discuss a few questions based on it. A few words have been taken from the poem and you have to tell me the rhyming words for each one of them. One has been done for you and it is team. So the rhyming word of team would be beam. You can also think of other words too. I will tell you how can you spell team. So the spelling of team is T-E-A-M. And the spelling of beam is B-E-A-M. Right, so the rhyming word of team would be beam. Moving on to the next word, it is plus. I'll repeat, plus. Now tell me children, what do you think? All right, I'm giving you time. Let me tell you the word which I thought. The rhyming word of plus could be bus or minus. Plus, minus, bus. There are so many rhyming words for it. Similarly, rhyming word for done could be none or gun. I repeat, the rhyming word for done could be none or gun. Next is hoop. Do you remember the word hoop? So now tell me the rhyming word of hoop. It could be loop, right? Tell me the rhyming word of goal. And this goal is spelled as G-O-A-L. So children, tell me the rhyming word of goal. It would be soul. So how do you spell it? S-O-U-L. Goal, soul. And after this, you have joy. What could be the rhyming word of joy? Yes, I'm very sure you already got the answer. It is toy. Joy, toy. And lastly, shoot. Shoot. So the rhyming word for shoot could be root. Shoot, root. Interesting, right? I know it must be. Now, could you please repeat these words for me? Beam, team. Plus, minus, bus, done, none, gun, hoop, loop, shoot, root, joy, toy, goal, soul. So, the words can be grouped together by a common sound, and these words are known as rhyming words. Don't forget to play this rhyming game with your family and friends. It would be great fun. I know. Lastly, I would say that the poem Teamwork, written by Jane Negro, is an important poem. It teaches us about the significance of teamwork. Moreover, we can learn about how it can benefit us in many ways. The poem cites examples of various sports. It makes it easier to understand the essence of teamwork. This way, we can all work together for a greater good. The poem promotes the spirit of teamwork and it benefits us all. I have another activity for you, dear children. I will be giving you some hints too. You have to guess the name of the game which it tells. So, let's begin. Here we go. You need a baton for this race. Which game it is? Keep guessing, children. It is relay race. Yes. Now, next is, there is a goalkeeper. Now tell me, dear children, which sport is it? There is a goalkeeper. It is football. Moving on, you shoot the ball in the hoop. You shoot the ball in the hoop. What is it? Tell me. It is basketball. And moving on, when one team bats the other fields. I'll repeat myself. When one team bats the other fields, what is it? Tell me, what is it? It's cricket. You must be enjoying it, right? I know. Lastly, so there is this game, children. You have to tell me. This game is also known as Who to Two. I'll repeat. Who to Two. You have to tell me the answer of this in the comment sections. This is your homework for you. Let us move on to the next game. The name of this game is Sentence Building. Yes, the name of this game is Sentence Building. As the name suggests, we will build sentences. What are we going to build, dear children? We are going to build sentences. And we will play this game in teams only. Later on, you can play this game with your friends and family. Now, I'll tell you what you have to do. I will give you a sentence. You have to add a word to that previous sentence and extend. For example, I went to the market and bought some bread. I'll repeat my sentence. This is the base sentence, children. I went to the market and bought some bread. You will add a word to the sentence and extend. For example, let's say, I went to the market and bought some bread and butter. Now the word butter has been added to the previous sentence. Similarly, you have to add a word to this sentence now. Interesting. Yes, I know it must be. Now think. I'll help you too. It should be like, I went to the market and bought some bread, butter and eggs. Now can you see, children? What did I do? I added eggs. And earlier, what did I add? Earlier, I added butter. So, the sentence goes, I went to the market and bought some bread, butter and eggs. Now I'll repeat all the three sentences for you so that you can understand it better. Sentence number one. I went to the market and bought some bread. Sentence number 2. I went to the market and bought some bread and butter. Sentence number 3. I went to the market and bought some bread, butter and eggs. See how interesting this activity is. You can play this with your friends easily. I would like to share an example of the current scenario. Entire world, including our nation, is fighting a constant battle from the past few months. My children, due to which you are not able to visit the school. In this situation, our country is fighting the pandemic as a team. Each and every person is doing his or her bit. The doctors and nurses are working round the clock, while the soldiers are fighting off Chinese movement near our borders. The cleaning workers are keeping the streets and markets clean. They all are risking their lives every day. We, teachers, are trying to teach you at their homes through the radio and computer. All this is possible because of mutual understanding, respect, and coordination. Yes, children, all this is possible because of mutual understanding, respect, and coordination. That is the reason that we should appreciate the efforts done by our health workers, teachers, police staff, and each and every person who is playing a role. Don't forget to appreciate yourself for accepting and adjusting in this situation at the time of pandemic and following all the guidelines given by the Government of India, taking all the safety measures, and most importantly, my dear children, staying indoors. I hope you enjoyed this session. Kindly share your valuable feedback. We'll meet you in another session. Now, very quickly, let us discuss the learning outcomes for this session. Children, by the end of this session, you understand the concept of teamwork. You appreciate and motivate the importance of teamwork in your daily lives. Repeat the rhyming words together, and you are able to repeat those rhyming words with correct pronunciation. All right, children. Bye for now. Take care. Stay safe. Namaskar.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. This program was recorded by Bati Langlingdo and technically assisted by Soumya Malik. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.